Hello YouTube, this is Alien Youth Games once again. This is Shabalagoo, part of the Alien Youth Games channel. Today we'll be making a game about Unturned. Yay! And since last time I reviewed the hack, but this time I'm not using the hack. I built a house. I have just a sleeping bag and two chests, and I got rid of all my hacked weapons. I tried to play like a normal person. It pretty much was cheating. So today, I'll be teaching people the awesomeness of the crossbow. Yeah, the crossbow. This is the best, in my opinion, this is the best weapon in the game. And I'll be teaching you also how to get into them. Everyone's heard of this military base. It's O'Leary's military base. It's on the map next to, like, it's Brattlewood or something. I don't know, but it's that town right there. And, it's, a lot of people say it's really hard to get into, because, I mean, there's armored zombies, and there's tons of them, too, so that makes it even worse, but, I am going to teach you how to get into it in a very easy way. All you really need is a crossbow, a lot of arrows, and you need to have a good aim. That's literally all you need. And you need to always shoot for the head. I mean, and you need to stay away because, I mean, getting too close, that'll attract all the zombies, and, well, that'll be kind of an issue, as you can pretty easily guess. So I'm going to teach you how to get into this base very easily without dying. Sure, you got to get a crossbow and maybe, like, get some armor and some, in case you run out of arrows, maybe get another gun, like, if you absolutely need it, but, honestly, the crossbow is all you really need, because it really is one of the best weapons in the game. And, they all come with a 6x zoom scope. You can try to find or craft a 12 or 20x zoom, or maybe a 7x zoom. And, it will really help with range, but honestly, if by the time that you really see the zombies, because you don't really start to see them until they're about 70 meters away, this will still work. It's not going to be too big of a deal to use this instead. I think I can hit this guy from here. I was right. See? So, this is how you get into this Canadian military base in a very short video. Sure, this actually takes a while, and it would probably be easier to do it with the Matamores, which is a very powerful sniper rifle. But, I'm sure this isn't exactly action-packed, but it will really help you in the future. And the crossbow is very silent. It makes absolutely no sound whatsoever. Unless, the only way the zombies will detect you is if, like, you're very close to them, and they can actually, like, see you. But otherwise, this is probably the best weapon to use because it doesn't make a sound. It comes with a scope by itself, and oh, he saw me. Okay, well, that was no big deal. Another good weapon to use is the compound bow, which it doesn't have a scope. You could probably get a sight for it, but it's still pretty good if they see you, if they come close, because the crossbow, technically speaking, you don't have to, oh crap, you don't have to aim to shoot, but it makes it easier to aim, it makes it easier to hit them, but the thing is, if they're close, it's not exactly the best idea. But this weapon is very good for close combat, and, oh my god, there's just a pile of zombies sitting here, and I'm surprised that, oh, one of them dropped a map. It's pretty useful. Oh crap. Okay. The good thing about this weapon is, whenever you aim, you can pretty much just quickscope them very easily. If you can get the aim right. Oh man, I'm already failing. This is the first time I've actually played it without using a hack in a while. Oh, crap. And, I've got armor on, that's why they haven't actually killed me yet. That or they just really suck. Which I think both of them are true. Crap. Yes. This thing can still hit them at long range, but you need to line up the line with their head, and, well, it's just really kind of annoying. The crossbow is still better. And the cool thing about arrows is that they're easy to make. All you need is, first you need an axe or a chainsaw, or just something to cut down a tree with. So yeah, an axe or a chainsaw. And then you need, once you get that, you cut down some trees to get sticks. And then any town you go into, like absolutely any, has nails all over the place. And then you just need some nails. Ooh, a ghillie suit. This is useful, a NATO tracer. It's good for a Swiss Gaver, or Gaver, whatever it's called, Gaver. And, ghillie suit, it just looks cool. NATO magazine, that's pretty good, but I don't have any space. And, shells, those are pretty useful. There's more zombies over here. But what I've always wondered is that, I don't know if it's not this military base, it's the much bigger one. It's actually an airport, I'm pretty sure. It's somewhere else on the map. It's enormous, but it has a plane in it. But I've never been able to get into it. I don't think you can, like anyone can, and I'm wondering why it's there. I mean, sure, it's probably just as decoration, but it would be pretty cool if you could use it. Maybe in an update, the game creator could perhaps make it to where you can use planes or get a plane. That, or at least someone could make like a mod or something where you can get into planes. And then there's gonna be tons of zombies like on the outside, but once you get on the inside and you've cleared this place of zombies, they really won't be big deal. And these towers always have interesting loot in them. Like one time I found a sleeping bag. It's pretty useful. I'm still using it actually. And that's pretty much all there is to it. You just need a crossbow, a bunch of arrows, and you need to stay far away from them and not do what I just did and accidentally shoot at them. And don't get too close, but if you do, then always have a compound or a recurve or longbow on hand, or maybe just a shotgun. But try to find a shotgun with a suppressor on it, or get a suppressor, because it will make it to where they can't really... Ooh, sandbags. Don't have any space. It will make it to where they cannot really... Don't need this, really. I don't need these at the moment. It will make it to where you really won't be detected if you have a suppressor. And that's really all there is to getting this base. There may be some stragglers. And, I hate this whole sorry no space thing. And more advice, get a rucksack. I'm pretty sure it's the largest backpack in the game. Either get that or a coyote pack, because this one allows you to where you have an extra column in your inventory, but with a coyote pack, you don't have that extra column, but you still have all these rows. You just don't have 5 columns, you have 4. And that's all there is to this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it useful. If you didn't already, if you want to find a crossbow, they can be easily found like on those 2 farms that are next to each other. Just in any town, there's a good chance of finding them, like in gun shops especially. And if you can't find a crossbow, at least find a bow and maybe get a sight. That, or just find a gun and put a suppressor on it and give that gun a scope. Or if you want to be really smart, just use a Madame Borez, because it has a built-in suppressor, and it also has a 7x zoom scope, and it has 10 bullets, so it's pretty easy. But the thing is, you need to get Extremen mags, which are not exactly impossible to find, but I haven't found many yet. In fact, I haven't even found the Matamoras. Well, that's it. Thank you for watching this video. So am I still waiting for this world to stop hating? Can't find a good reason, can't find hope to believe in.